All right, YouTube, David Harry here, and in this video, I'm going to be using my iPad Mini 6 locked off on a tripod and testing the front camera, which is what I'm on right now, and the rear camera as well, just to give ourselves a really good idea as to how useful this could be for maybe some serious type of film, and you never know. Anyway, just a quick little setup thing here. I'm just going to film it with my Sony ZV-1 so we can see what's going on. So there's the iPad Mini 6 there. I've got this Ulanzi case on it, which is a bumper case, which also has a magnetic thing that flips over to turn it into a trifold. It is an awesome case. And then what I've got here, as we can see, that is the receiver off a Rode Lavalier, sorry, a Rode Wireless Go. I've actually got the Rode Lavalier Go as well, because that's plugged onto me. I'll show you that in a second. Then the cable in there, that's the Apple headphone adapter. And then that's obviously able to take a mic input. And then the cable going into that is a Rode TRS to TRRS, which is what you have to use because the Apple cable is TRRS. And then there is the back of the Mini 6, and then there's the rear lens there, which we will get onto momentarily. So let me just get back around to the front here. Okay, so that's going to give you like a rundown of all the stuff that I'm using. Obviously, it's on a tripod. I've just got basically this really nice Manfrotto tripod here. So what I'm going to do anyway, I'm just going to show you what it's going to be like to use a wireless lav system with this. I'll give you a quick example as well of the internal mic shortly. But just for now, because I'm on a wireless mic system, I can move around with it. So what it is, I've got the Rode Lavalier Go concealed under here. So hopefully we should have heard that then. And then what it is, that's plugged into the transmitter on my pocket there. Oh, actually, I'll stay over here because this is the reason for using the wireless system. So you can walk away a little bit, away from, you know, the camera and stuff, or away from the iPad. So I'll just move about a little bit here. Now, the thing is, this is like, you know, the Rode Wireless Go, basically. So you have to be careful how far you go away. But, you know, as long as you're within like a reasonable distance, you could do this and move about and stuff. So you might actually have the iPad Mini 6 with you somewhere, and you might want to film somebody else doing something, or maybe you might want to interview someone or do something like that, in which case, yeah, you know, this is going to give you a really, really good example of like what that would be like. Okay, so let me just get back up to here a bit. So what I'm going to do now is flip over onto the rear camera, because I think this might be the thing that might swing it for people. Okay, so just onto the rear camera now, and quickly an example of what the internal microphones are like. Now, you can easily use the internal mics if you want to. I'm just using the like wireless system so I can walk away from it. However, it is like not breezy right now, so this will give you a good idea of the internal mics when it's not breezy. So you could probably easily get away with this. And just so you can see, I'm tapping my lavalier. It's not plugged in, so let me flip back over to the lavalier. Okay, so back over to my wireless lav now, so hopefully we should be able to hear it when I tap it there. So anyway, the rear camera is a higher resolution camera. Dare I say, it's a better camera as well. So this will definitely give you a really good example of what this is capable of looking like. Now, what I'm going to do again, because I've got the wireless system on, I'll start moving around. The only thing is here, I don't know where I'm going to be in the frame, obviously, because I can't see it now. But I'll try and stay in line with the camera, move around a little bit. But again, just to give you an idea of what these things are like, basically. And I think it's going to give you a really good idea as to whether or not you would like, well, it definitely let you know if you could use something like this for something similar to this. Like I say, it just could be like a family event. It could be absolutely anything. You might just be out and about and you've got the iPad with you, and you just might want to just film something that's to hand or whatever, could be anything. So hopefully what this video is going to have done is to give you a really good idea of, like, you know, what is achievable with the front and the back cameras, obviously in this locked off position. Let me try and get back to the right position there. Anyways, I think that should just about do it then for this video. Yeah, so there we have it then, YouTube. This video should have been a really good example for you to know exactly what the front and the back cameras of the iPad mini 6 look like when they're locked off on a tripod. Now everything that I've used in the video will be available in the description below, and also as well I do a lot more vloggy stuff on a different channel, so if you're into the vlog and stuff, cameras and microphones, and probably more so more of a technical deep dive on stuff, check that channel out. There'll be a link in the description and at the end of the video. However, I have to warn you, I do use colorful language on that other channel, and I also use bleeped swearing, so be warned of that. Also, if you've liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, consider subscribing to the channel and getting on the bell notification icon, especially if you're into stuff to do with iPads, iPhones, Macs and things like that, and basically all kinds of tech nonsense. Anyways, I'm David Harry. Thank you very much for watching this video. Take care and goodbye now.